Hey, my kings and queens, it's your girl Destiny Dynasty, and I'm back with a hitter, make a quitter, make them other YouTubers wish they woulda, period. And today is Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving, my loves. Happy Thanksgiving. Today I'm making apple pie, Dutch apple pie. I'm about to start peeling my apples. I already washed them off. So I'll get back to you when I am starting. So I started off by cutting off the surrounding, the top part. And now I'm gonna take out the core. I'm gonna try. I like to cook, if you guys don't know. Come to Aunty Desi house. She got all the goods. Got it. Boom. And now I'm about to start the pili-pili process. Pili-pili-pili-pili-pili-pili. I should have my glasses on. But I cut off my finger. But I can see enough. We'll be back. So I got a few of them already, you know, peeled, and I took the centers out. I'm gonna start slicing them now. So what you're gonna do is I'm gonna move these over so you can see these peelings over. You're gonna cut it down the middle. You wanna take the center out with the seeds up out of it.
You keep.
That's my godson that you hear in the background. I might do a voiceover. But I'm trying not to because I don't really like voiceovers. It's nothing like the real deal. So I took the center out, the core out, up out of that thing. Now, you're going to cut it down the middle. And then you're gonna get it like this, nice and like this.
I'm not shoes.
And then, Ryan, I'm doing a video, baby.
I don't want, I need to get this cookie.
And then you wanna cut it again, down.
I want the cookie now.
And now, this is how it's gonna look. Nice, see, I'm gonna bring it closer. This is how it's gonna look. You got them thinner, it depends on how chunky you want your, apple pie to be. I like mine with a little chunky pumpkin. Yeah, that's how you slice the apples. You slice it, get it nice and ready. Hey y'all, so now we're gonna start prepping our apples before we put in our pie crust. You need to get you some white sugar and put it evenly on the apples. And some brown cinnamon. I'm not measuring it because I've been doing this for a while, but I put the measurements in the description down below. But I put some white sugar and some cinnamon on the apples. This is my cinnamon and sugar mixture. You need to mix it up. I'm not using a spatula. You can use a spatula if you want. I'm using my hands because I like to be hands-on. Make sure you evenly get that sugar and cinnamon mix all over all the apples because that's going to be the flavor for the filling of the pie. So you start to put the apples into the pie crust. I'm using pie crust that was frozen because I didn't have time to make pie crust from scratch because I was pressed for time. Make sure your apples is evenly into the pie crust as possible. And now I'm going to start making my topping, which is going to be made from flour, self-rising flour. Make sure you get you some self-rising flour, some white sugar, and some softened butter. Do not melt the butter. Just let it get soft. So I'm going to start mixing those together. You can either use two forks to press out the butter into the flour and the sugar mixture to make little dots because we're making Dutch apple pie, so it's gonna be like crumbs on the top. It's like sweet crumbs. But I'm not using forks. I'm like I told you, I'm hands on. I like to feel it. I like to make sure, you know, it's the right texture and everything that I just gotta use my hands. I'm a hands on person. My hands are clean, of course. But you start mixing up that softened butter, sugar, and the self-rising flour. Of course, you're going to have to, you know, make sure you're using enough sugar or make sure it's sweet enough to your taste. As you see, I finally got done with it. It's the dots. Like I said, you don't want it to be mush. It needs to be dots, like little crumbs. It got to be crumbs because this is Dutch pie. You spread it evenly over the top of your apple pie. You make sure all the apples are covered. You pat it down as you go. You don't have to pat it until it's flat because, like I said, you want it to be crumbs. Yeah, this is the final touch you see. Now it's nice and ready to go into the oven.
You have to put your pie in the oven for 10 minutes on 450, then 40 minutes on 350. My apple pies are done. They look amazing. And look, it's bubbling.
Mm. That bite, girl. Show them that bite of that apple pie.
Look.
1-800-APPLE-PIE.
1-800-APPLE.
1-800-what?
Apple.
Apple.
It was delicious.
It was perfect.
How was it when it touched your tongue?
It wasn't too sweet.
It just had the right amount of crunch. Everything was just properly put together.
Go ahead,
just
eat it.
That's
how
I don't know if I can eat.
And
that sounds
delicious. I'm already full.
I'm sorry. This is the second pie that I'm taking home.
Okay, let's show them the first one.
That's the
first one. After the slide.
Already. Have one of the apple pie. Never failing, all things
are working for my good.
Cause he's intentional.
He's intentional.
Hey, and he's never failing.
Never.